So a breaking news first alert, and right now firefighters are mopping up a fire that damaged two businesses overnight. It is happening in the 6,000 block of 65th Street.
KCR3's Richard Sharp joining us now live at the scene with why firefighters are calling this suspicious.
Yeah, Deirdre, in just the last few minutes, they've put up the security fence behind us here to keep the building safe. And before investigators can get in, they want to make sure everything has been checked out and the investigators finish their job. But you can see how much damage is done. The whole glass front of the building is gone, and the roof of the building looks like it's sagging, almost caving in. Now, take a look at the video we shot just a few minutes ago. Both the fire department and the building's owner say this security door was tried to break into. Some thieves tried to get into it with a welding torch, and they believe that's where the fire started, with that welding torch. Now, the fire started in the back of the building in that area. The building was home to two businesses, Galaxy Furniture and Tool Outlet. Both are completely destroyed. And when firefighters got to the building, it was already so engulfed with flames, they didn't take any chances. They called for a second engine to help out.
Due to the amount of involvement, it went defensive pretty quick, and we got additional resources and set up in a defensive posture. So it's a different strategy, and it's just keeping the firemen safe and making sure it doesn't spread to any exposure buildings. We had an exposure building over here on the Bravo side.
So right next to this building, another building that they were concerned about that could have caught fire easily and just feet away. Fire investigators are on their way out to the scene. They have to figure out exactly what caused that fire. But at this point, the building owner believes it was likely a welding torch from the thieves trying to break in. And the building's owner also tells me that over the past 6 years or so, there have been several break-ins in the tool part of this building, people trying to get at some of the tools that were part of this business. Live in Sacramento County, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 Reports.